everyone. Today, we will learn step-by-step SPSS data analysis with a statistical test, the classical Wallis hash test. Learning the statistical test without knowing its functions in research is meaningless. Therefore, we will learn the test with a research example and its data. From the research example, we will first state the research hypothesis and then analyze the data in SPSS step by step to test the hypothesis and finally report the results and findings. At the end of this video, there is an exercise and you can download the SPSS data or the exercise and practice your data analysis skill. Everything will be very simple and very easy to understand. So, let us start. The classical Wallis hash test is a rank-based non-parametric test used to determine if there are statistically significant differences between two or more groups of an independent variable on ordinal scale dependent variable. Its function is similar to the one-way ANOVA test, and it is a non-parametric method to the one-way ANOVA. Thus, it is also called one-way ANOVA test on ranks. The difference is the dependent variable of one-way ANOVA test is measured in continuous scale, which is either in interval or ratio scale. However, the dependent variable of classical Wallis hash test is measured in categorical scale, which is ordinal scale. Example of an ordinal scale variable is the Likert scale, labeled in rank order 1 equal to strongly disagree to 5 equal to strongly agree. The independent variable is the grouping variable with at least two groups. Example of grouping variable are gender, age level, field of study, education levels, etc. Because the classical Wallis hash test is a non-parametric test, there is no normality assumption of the data. The following is an example research of data analysis using the classical Wallis hash test. In this example, a research is conducted to investigate whether there are differences between psychology, business, and computer programming students in emotional intelligence. In this research, the independent variable is field of study, and the dependent variable is emotional intelligence or EQ. The objective of the research is to compare emotional intelligence between the three fields of study, one, psychology, two, business, and three, computer programming. The two variables in the rectangles and the single-headed arrows form a conceptual framework of this causal comparative design research. The research data is collected from 80 students, 39 psychology students, 19 business students, and 22 computer programming students using an emotional intelligence questionnaire. There are 6 items in the questionnaire, field of study, and 5 EQ items. The data collected is tabulated and we will use this data for data analysis in SPSS. But before analyzing the data, the researcher needs to state the research hypothesis for hypothesis testing. There are 6 hypotheses. The hypotheses 1 to 5 are similar, but each one states a different aspect of the EQ. The hypothesis 6 stating the difference between the three groups in the total EQ. In this study, The null hypothesis is true if p value of the classical Wallis Hess test is larger or equal to 0.05. However, if the p value of the classical Wallis Hess test is smaller than 0.05, the research hypothesis is true, and we will reject the null hypothesis. This concept must be very clear before we analyze the data in SPSS. Now we will analyze the data using the classical Wallis Hess test to test the research hypothesis.